Hi friends, welcome to Pictures and Paintings.
Unlike other cats, lions are very social animals. They live in groups of around 30 to 40 lions, and it's called prides. A pride can consist of up to 3 males, a dozen related females, and their young ones. To start off, the first challenge I encountered was handling a bigger sized paper. I was doing this painting on a 16 by 23 inch sheet. This was easily double the size of what I normally used to paint. I approached it the same way as any of the other paintings. I first blocked the shapes very, very roughly and got my spacing right. I had to ensure the tail of the right hand side lioness was inside the frame, and there was enough gap between the lost lioness on the left hand side and the end of the sheet. Once I got all these right, I started firming up my sketching. When I picked up this reference image, I wanted to bring out the organic feel to the lionesses. So I ensured during the pencil sketching stage itself, I captured all the necessary muscle and skin fold information. At this stage, I was also making up my mind on what kind of background I want, how much I wanted to show, and whether I want to leave it as an open field or give it a dense cover. But I was sort of clear with one thing. While the idea was to make the lionesses look realistic, I wanted the background to look a little surreal, so that it looks like a painting rather than a processed photograph. Penciling the reflection of the lionesses in the water was fun. By this time, I had already spent quite a lot of time just sketching. So I thought I will keep the reflection pretty simple in the sketching stage, and then while painting, I will paint in all the details. The only thing I took care while sketching the reflection was to ensure they are aligned with the characters. The painting process itself was fairly straightforward. My game plan was to concentrate and do a good job painting the lionesses on either ends. I had a strong feeling if I get both of them right, I would be able to get away by painting a little lesser details with the ones in between. Since there were four characters in the painting and none of them were extremely closer, I did not have to go in and paint too much of a detail. All I had to do was ensure it works from this distance. And one of the initial decisions, again, which was a little tricky for me to make, was the right skin tone for the lionesses. So I kept it around the yellow-brown tones. To be honest, in my paintings, I don't give too much importance to exactly match the skin tones to the reference pictures. As long as it is in the ballpark and looks appealing to our eyes, I am fine with them. Another interesting point to note here is lions staying as groups definitely gives them an edge. Males and females take on a different role in the pride. Male lions spend their time guarding their territory and their cubs. They maintain the boundary of their territory. And sometimes these territories we are talking about can be as large as 260 square kilometers. Because of their smaller size and being more agile than male, female lions are the primary hunters of the group. They have a game plan and work as a team to attack their prey. They fan out and form a semicircle with the smaller and weaker lionesses herding the prey towards the center. Then the stronger females knock the animal down and make the kill. Pride members keep track of one another by roaring. Both males and females have a very powerful roar which could be heard up to 8 kilometers away. Interestingly, the size of the pride is determined by the availability of food and water. If resources are scarce, the pride becomes smaller. Female cubs are allowed to stay with the group as they age. At around 2 years old, they become capable hunters. But young males are forced out of the pride at that age. They form a bachelor group and follow migrating herds until they are strong enough to challenge male lions of other prides. In general, a group of males stays in power in the pride for around 3 years before another bachelor group takes it over. Most of the other predators from the cat family that we know, like tiger, leopard, cheetah, they are mostly solitary. Interesting, right? Once the base coat was painted on the lionesses, I started adding details from the left-hand side lioness. While this was occupying a prominent position within the picture, we don't see the full lioness, and I had lesser surface area to cover. I ensured the small little texture patterns, like the spots you see in the legs, are all included in the painting to give it a believable look. The lion cubs have spots on them when they are born, and as they grow, it becomes less prominent. Observing and painting small little details like these goes a long way in ensuring paintings look believable. When it was time to paint the lioness on the right hand side, to be honest, I was a little nervous because this lioness occupies a prominent portion of the painting, and I was really worried about how the body would turn up. So I went about slowly building in the layers. I first did a very pale wash of the skin folds, and then started adding details to the hind legs. Once the spots and muscular details were coming together and the legs started looking right, it gave me a lot of confidence to proceed forward. In fact, the 2-3 skin folds that you see next to the forelegs plays a crucial role in establishing the muscular nature of all the four lines in this entire picture. Something as small and simple as that can play a vital role. So when I finished painting this lioness, I felt so good and happy to see the way the picture was turning out. Lions usually hunt at night, and because they hunt as a group, they can actually bring down animals that are much larger than them in terms of the size. They are known to bring down young elephants, rhinos, hippos, other than their usual prey of antelopes, buffaloes, zebras, and interestingly, they can even bring down a giraffe. After a successful hunt, all the lions in the pride share the meal. But there is a pecking order. The adult males take the first climb, followed by the lionesses, and finally the cubs. When we talk of food, another interesting fact is that sometimes they eat smaller prey like mice, birds, hares, lizards, and tortoise. Basically, when they are hungry, what comes in front of them can turn into their dinner or a lunch. This painting is all about lionesses quenching their thirst. So let's talk a little bit about their drinking habits as well. If available, they drink water every day. But the interesting point to note is they can also go without drinking for 4 to 5 days. They obtain the moisture from the content of their prey. Interesting, right? While I keep referring to all the four of them as lionesses, if you watch it closely, the second one from right-hand side is actually a young male. You can see the growing mane painted.
Painting these lionesses was a wonderful experience. When I started this painting, I had one goal in my mind, which was to make them look organic. I wanted the muscular feel to be coming out, and pretty much when I completed this, I was happy about it. One interesting part which I definitely wanted to share is the original plan was to paint the four lionesses and then get a mirror reflection of them on the water. Keep the water crystal clear with a good reflection. But then as I started, I realized the amount of work which was involved. So by the time I had finished painting the four lionesses, I was in some ways exhausted. So I wanted to keep it simple. Then I changed from the original plan and then kept the reflection very subtle and added a lot of elements on the water to cheat the amount of reflection I had to paint. I felt it was a good improvisation, but then was not a good planning on my side. And because of that, I had to do a little bit of damage control and things like that. But then towards the end, how it had come out was still working and I'm happy. And the background on this, like in many of my recent paintings, the background is completely modified from the reference image. I painted it again mostly from my imagination. I did not have good references. It was mostly made up. What do you think of this painting? Don't forget to leave your comments in the comments column below. I'll be eagerly waiting to read. Thank you for watching this till the end. See you soon in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.